Hey guys, what's up? I hope you're doing well. So let's get started with the components now. Okay, before going to the individual components, let's have a look at the layout. Layout is a very integral part of any website. It helps you to place all the different components that you have seen before in your website in any possible manner that you want. Okay, and before this, I would like to tell you how to read these documentations. On the left side, you can see that we have a column dedicated having all the headings. In the center, we have the main content, and on the right, we have the summary. You can click on all these links and go to that respective link. Now, let's get started with the layout. And in the layout, the first topic is grid. The grid system. So as the word says grid, it just gives you a lot of rows and columns that you can set. Now let's read this. Bootstrap's grid system uses a series of containers, rows and columns. So to create a grid, these three things are what we are going to import in our code. Also, it uses the flexbox and it is fully responsive. That means the React Bootstrap grid system is fully responsive since it uses the flexbox. So that is really helpful. Anyways, so now let's have a look at the code. Suppose you want to create a row that has two columns, column 1 and column 2. Then how would you do it? And after this, in the second row, you want to create three columns. Column 1, column 2, column 3. So to do this, the code is given right over here. As I said, the documentation is really great and very self-explanatory also. So let's get started. Here we first have the container tag, and here is its closing tag. Then we have the row tag and the column tag. Here you can see that they have used a row, and inside of row they have placed two columns, and these are the two columns. And below this we can see that there is another row tag having column 1, column 2 and column 3, and this will create this. It is as simple as that. Now let's just copy this and try it in our very own code editor. Now I'll be using the app.js file to demonstrate the grid system. Your app.js file will be looking exactly like this if you use the create react app package. I'll delete all the content that comes with it inside this div, and then I'll paste what we copied from the website. I'll also remove the class name to remove any styling that comes with it. You can also go to the app.cs file and delete all the styling. Now let's go back to the app.js. We have pasted the code, but we haven't imported all these components. So let's import these components. So this is how you'll import these three components from React Bootstrap. Now let's just save the file and run the script. It might take some time. And here you can see that we have these two columns in the first row and three columns in the third row. But you cannot see the borders because there is no styling at the moment. Let me style this so that it is easier to visualize. I've given the two rows the class name rows. Now I'll be giving the columns the class name of columns. And I'll copy this and paste it below. Okay. And same with these. Now, having the class names in place, let's go to the app.css file and let's give them some styling. I'll give them a border of 2 pixel, solid and red. Sorry. And the columns will get a border of 2 pixel solid black. Let's save the file and let's go to the browser. What's wrong? Now let's just save the file and go back, and you can see now the rows have a border of 2 pixel and is of red color, and the columns have a border of 2 pixel and are of black color. Now we can just open our developer tools by going to more tools and developer tools, and we'll be changing to mobile view for a second. You can see that the rows and columns are responsive. This is because React Bootstrap uses Flexbox internally. Let's close these tools and go back to VS Code. Let's go back to the website and see what's next. Now, as you know that we can also create responsive grids with React Bootstrap, and we also know that it uses Flexbox on the inside. We can use attributes like SM, which stands for small, and there are a lot more attributes. You can check these attributes by going to the API column, and you can see all the attributes that the column tag can get, which is LG, which stands for large, medium, small, extra large, extra small. So you can all these attributes and give them values. Now let me show you an example of these. Suppose you want the one of two column to take 75% of space of the total width. How will you do it? You can do that by adding LG is equal to 8, and you will have to add LG is equal to 8 to the first column, and LG is equal to 4 to the second column. Let's go back, and now you can see that it is taking 75% of the space, or maybe not 75%, but yeah, two-thirds of space that is available. So what this basically does is, if you know about Flexbox, then we know that the screen is divided into 12 small columns, and out of those we have given 8 columns to the first column, and the remaining 4 columns are given to the second column. So this is how the Flexbox works in React Bootstrap. Let's go back to the documentation now. There are a lot of things that you can do in the layout section, like you can arrange the columns in various ways, like this or this or this. All this can be done by just using attributes like these, and this is also very simple to understand, so I'll leave it to the user, and I hope you read these. And then if you have any problem, please feel free to comment below. For example, you can use the order property inside the axis attribute like this. What this will do is, it will just place this column in the end, and in the third column we can see that order has been defined as 1. This means this column will appear first. So you can see that it is as simple as that. Now let's move ahead and let's move to media. Media objects are not very complex. We can see that the React Bootstrap website provides us an example code, and this code will create this. We can see that the first tag that they have used is media tag, and after that they have used a simple HTML image tag having a width, a height and a class name of MR3, which is a Bootstrap class that will give the margin right of 3. You can see that there is space on the right of the image, so that comes via this, and the source, that is the image source and the alternate description. After that, inside the media tag there is another tag, media.body. This is the tag where the main content of the media will go, like the media heading, which comes under an h5, which is again an HTML tag and a paragraph tag. So as you can see that it is very simple to implement it, and let's just give it a try and let's copy this code and let's try it in our editor. Let's delete the previous code and let's paste the code that we just copied. There are some changes that we'll need to make. First being, we'll need to import the media tag. The next one being, we'll also need to change the source of the image, since we don't have this image. So we'll just use the logo image that Create React app provides us. Let's save the file and let's go back to the browser. Now you can see that we are getting the same thing that is there in the documentation. Also, this will also be responsive. Let's test it. You can see that the text wrapped itself depending on the viewport, so it is also responsive. Now with this, we come to the end of this video, and I'd like to thank you if you have stayed till the end. I'd also like to request you to please subscribe to my channel and like the video. Bye, see you in the next one. Maybe it's 3 a.m. Had you on my mind, and it's not the first time we've gone through this. Tell me pretty lies, look me in the face, tell me that you love me, even if it's